Don't be locked. Double down. Three opponents down. Shut the enemy down. Triple down. Look at them fall.
2-for-1.
Yes. Three down. Look at them fall.
Ladies and gents, my name is Xander, aka Deicide, and in this video, we're gonna find out as to which one of these two monsters, the Galliard 42 or the Summoner, is really the best between the two, and which one just might be able to call Ramrod against a couple unsuspecting Guardians. The main reason as to why we're doing this video is because of you, my friends. You Deicelayers have been asking me ever since I made that 9 Hunger vs. Summoner video to do one versus the Summoner and the Galliard, and lo and behold, here it finally is. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at the weapon's perks, their TTK stats, their base stats, the sights, in particular the SPO-28 front sight, as well as some other things according to Zen Moment and those types of perks, and lastly some range and bullet magnetism tests to really see as to which one stands out amongst all those categories. Before we go any further, what you guys have got to understand though first is how to get your hands on each one of these two beauties. And for the Summoner, all you gotta simply do is just go and play Trials and earn the weapon either at 3, 5, or 7 wins, maybe at the Flawless Lighthouse chest, and then when you got it in your pocket, all you gotta do is then turn in some more Trials tokens to Saint 14, and maybe if RNG luck is on your side, more of these bad boys will drop. As far as the Galliard goes, well for that, it's gonna be even more RNG luck, because what you gotta do to get this is to go into the Black Armory Forges and simply complete those, and hope and pray that maybe, just ever so slightly, a good roll is gonna drop. That might have something like, say, Kill Clip, which by the way, we're going to test out and see how it stacks up to Rampage versus the Summoner as well. May the odds be ever in your favor, my friends, and so the only thing left to do is just to simply sit back, relax, grab some popcorn, and eviscerate the notification button, and let's jump right to the video. Now there's many Guardians out there who think that the Galliard is better than the Summoner, and vice versa, and what this really comes down to is actually a couple of things, in particular, Zen Moment on the Summoner, Dynamic Sway Reduction on the Galliard, as well as the SPO-28 front sight on the Galliard once again. What you have to understand first is all the rolls that I happen to have on both my Summoner and two Galliards, and you guys can see those with the Summoner right there on screen. This Summoner is wonderful because it's got Rampage, Zen Moment, Flared Magwell, Arrowhead Break, a Reload Masterwork, and a Rampage Spec mod. On the other hand, we also have my first Galliard, and that one's got a delicious combination with Kill Clip and Outlaw, mixed with Extended Magazine, the SLO-10 post sight, a Handling Masterwork, and a Counterbalance mod. Ensuing this is the second Galliard that I have, and this beauty right here has High Impact Reserves, Dynamic Sway Reduction, Ricochet Rounds, the SPO-28 front sight, a Range Masterwork, and a Counterbalance mod. The key principles that I want you to take away from seeing all those perks and sights is that the Summoner has Zen Moment. My first Galliard has the SLO-10 post sight, and my second Galliard not only has Dynamic Sway Reduction, but more importantly, the SPO-28 front sight. Depending upon who you ask, those things that I just mentioned is what makes the reticles and the sights a complete laser beam. And so to really test this out, what I want to do is I want to go into a private match, play all these sights in real time and in slow motion, and then replay them again, so then you guys can really see as to exactly what's happening with the reticle, and see as exactly how much each one of these things are really moving. First up is that Summoner, and oh my goodness gracious, this thing, guys, is just a complete laser beam. I mean, it just doesn't miss. As soon as I start to land body shots intentionally against this Guardian, that sight just literally doesn't move. I mean, it's so precise, it's baffling. And bada bing, bada boom, not even Iron Man's repulsors could be that precise. However, the same thing cannot be said for the SLO-10 post sight on the Galliard, and you guys can see that the reticle, in contrast to the sight itself, is just moving all over the place. I mean, it's going up, down, left, right, and you can tell that definitely there is some fluff cabbage trash shenanigans going on, and you don't want that, I don't want that, nobody wants that. But what about what we're all really curious at, and that is the Galliard with number 1, Dynamic Sway Reduction, and number 2, the SPO-28 front sight. Without any further suspense, you guys can see from right here that yes, there is a teeny tiny bit of improvement in contrast to the SLO-10 post sight, but I won't lie, that improvement is pretty much null and void, and it's very, very minuscule at the very, very least. And so even if you happen to have a Galliard with something like this, SPO-28 front sight and Dynamic Sway Reduction, that's not going to be nearly as good as what the Summoner can be with having Zen Moment. Even if you happen to be on the other side of the map, and I truly do mean that, cross map distances, this Summoner with Zen Moment can just be a true laser beam with so much precision that's just gonna be mind-boggling and baffling in so many ways. But unfortunately, the Galliard can never ever do this, and so to you I say, the proof is in the pudding, and lo and behold, the Summoner and its Sight with Zen moment is clearly the winner here in this respect. And understanding that, what you gotta comprehend next is these weapons' TTK stats. And both the Summoner and the Galliard are actually in the exact same archetype, and thus they have the same optimal time to kill and body shot TTKs respectively. To be more precise, each one of these two beauties is then going to take 13 body shots at a Guardian at 10 resilience or tier 10 resilience, and thus get that body shot TTK at 1.2 seconds. As far as the optimal time to kill goes, well, here's where things get really interesting, as these two things only need 8 crits to get the weapon's optimal time to kill at, once again, a Guardian at 10 or a tier 10 resilience, and thus get the weapon's optimal TTK at 0.7 seconds. I know, the optimal TTK is just nuts. I mean, it makes me say, what the heck is going on? Because it melts you that freaking fast, kinda like a knife through butter. But what I want to show you next is what each one of these two things can do with Rampage, and you guys can see that right there on screen. On the left, we had the Summoner with its base TTK stats. But in the center, we got Rampage times 2, and on the right-hand side, we got Rampage times 3. Some of you might be wondering, okay, well, why am I not seeing Rampage times 1? And the reason is because Rampage times 1 is doing the exact same optimal time to kill as the weapon's base TTK stats with, once again, 10 resilience. However, Rampage times 1 and Rampage times 2 is a completely different story, as Rampage times 2 can get an optimal TTK at 0.6 seconds, and Rampage times 3 can get one at 0.5 seconds. I know, there is some lunacy up in here, but even so, what I want to repeat one more time is that Rampage can only roll on the Summoner for its damage buffing perk. The Summoner can't roll with something like, say, Kill Clip or Multi-Kill Clip or anything else along those lines, but as far as the Galliard goes, it can. And it can roll with not just Rampage, but also with Kill Clip. If RNG luck is with you and you happen to get a Galliard that happens to have Kill Clip, oh baby, this Galliard's gonna hit you like a truck, kinda what you felt like after having a fantastic party. But having said that, the weapon's optimal time to kill with Kill Clip proc is at 0.5 seconds. Just that we're all on the exact same page, what I wanna do is I wanna put all the Galliard in its TTK stats with Kill Clip and Rampage in the weapon's base TTK stats right there on screen. On the left, we happen to have the weapon in its base TTK stats, with Rampage times 1 in the center, and Kill Clip on the right-hand side. A couple things that I want to point out is that yes, the Galliard and the Summoner can both roll with Rampage, and thus you can have Rampage times 1 with a Guardian at 6 resilience and still get that same optimal TTK as Rampage times 2 at 0.6 seconds. I did a complete video on why resilience counters not just auto rifles but also a shotgun meta, and I'll link that up in the top right-hand corner of your screen. So if you're interested, then by all means, please do check that out. But as far as Kill Clip goes, what the main difference here is that Kill Clip only needs one kill after reloading to actually get that kind of TTK factor. But with Rampage, that's not the same, because you not just need one, two, but three kills to finally get that same optimal TTK at 0.5 seconds. I got a hunch that a couple of you are thinking, well, Xander, that definitely means that Kill Clip is a clear winner here. And to you I say, initially, yes, you're correct. But what you also gotta take into account is the other perks that are then on the weapon, as well as the playstyle in which you have. If you're a super hyper-aggressive playstyle player like myself, then what you might want to have is something like, say, Rampage, because there may not simply be enough time to regain your health and then go into the next engagement, and thus you'll automatically have that damage buff. But on the other hand, you could also say this the vice versa way of that, and that is that maybe if you want to get into cover, reload, then you'll have a completely better damage buffing perk with a much, much faster TTK. Alright. So now that I've kind of played the devil's advocate, what I want you to recall is what I mentioned there previously, and that is the perk combination in which these things have. And so that then brings me to my next point, and that is that all the perks that these things can roll with can then make or break the weapons completely. As you guys can see from right there on screen, here's all the weapons perks with the Summoner on the left and the Galliard on the right. The first notable difference is the very first column, in that on the left with the Summoner, it's got muzzle brake options. So that's not going to change the sight, but rather it's going to change the range, the stability, etc, etc. But for the Galliard, that's not the same at all, as its first column is not only going to change the sight in terms of short, medium, and long zoom scopes, but it's also then going to change the range, the handling, etc, etc, and that right there is a key distinctive difference. What you probably already noticed, and something that is definitely noteworthy, is that the Summoner and its third and fourth column only have 5 perks in each column, but for the Galliard, it happens to have 7. And so right there, you're going to have a much, much greater chance of getting the right roll that you want on the Galliard versus the Summoner. As far as the perks themselves goes, The Gallagher definitely has one thing that really stands out, and that is Kill Clip and its fourth and final column. And the same thing is not said for the Summoner, as it's only got Rampage, but then again, the Gallagher can also have that. However, something that the Summoner does have and something that the Gallagher cannot have is Zen Moment in its third column. But what I also want you to be mindful of is that the Gallagher has Quick Draw where the Summoner doesn't. Now I know that you, nor I, nor anybody out there can actually control what kind of draw that they're going to get, as much as what we would like. Bungie, if you're listening, maybe give us some options to do so in the future. But hey, as of right now, all we gotta rely on is RNG luck. And so maybe if RNG is on your side, you're gonna get that phenomenal God Roll and potentially making the Guardians a little bit salty. But for right now, whatever kind of perks that you're then going to get are then going to affect the weapon's base stats. And this then brings us to our next point in that which one of these two weapons is actually better in terms of their base stats. Just as a quick little reminder, here's all the rolls that I happen to have on my Summoner, as well as what I happen to have on my Gallagher, specifically with the Outlaw and Kill Clip roll. And so these types of perks are then going to affect the weapon's base stats cumulatively, and you guys can see those right there on screen. When it comes to range and stability, each one of these two weapons and their base stats are pretty much only differing by less than 5, and that's negligible at the very, very least. But as far as handling and reload speed goes, that's definitely not negligible because the Summoner and its handling and reload is at 73 and 60, in contrast to the Gallagher at 56 and 47. Going down just a smidge, you'll see that the aim assistance is only differing by 2, and that's pretty much null and void, but the recoil direction is very, very different, one at 57 and one at 70. All the other base stats are pretty much almost identical, and you're really not going to notice the difference between them. But just to be on the safe side, what I wanted to do is I wanted to test out each one of these three weapons' effective ranges, and of course we gotta go into a Pride Match to really test this out. As you guys can see from right here, I'm taking out my Darcy and measuring 23 meters. As I do so, I then take out my Summoner, and lo and behold, it does 26 per crit. Going back only one more meter to 24 meters, we then see a little bit of a damage reduction to be at exactly 25, and thus this tells us that this weapon's optimal effective range, with having absolutely no range increasing perks at all, is then going to be at 23 meters. Doing this exact same test with the Gallagher and specifically the SLO-10 post sight, we then happen to see that at 23 meters, it's doing what we would expect, 26 per crit. Going back just a tiny little bit to 24 meters, we then see that it's doing a little bit of damage fall off to be at 25 meters, and so this then tells us that this weapon also has no range increasing perks, and thus its optimal effective range is at 23 meters. Lastly, we then have the Gallagher with the SBO-28 front sight. And not only does it have that, but it's also got ricochet rounds and a ranged masterwork. And here we see a crazy amount of difference in that the weapon's base range is at 32 meters by measuring of that Darcy. Lo and behold, this thing is then doing a teeny tiny bit less damage at 25 per crit, telling us that the weapon's optimal effective range with the SBO-28 front sight, ricochet rounds, and a ranged masterwork is at 32 meters. The main takeaway that I want you guys to see from this is that with no range increasing perks, the Summoner and the Gallagher are identical across the board, at least in terms of their effective range. But as soon as you happen to include some range perks as well as ranged masterwork, all of a sudden, we have a 9-meter range difference, and that is just craziness. Dia Slayers, I can't tell you as to how colossal of a difference that actually is, because that right there means that you can do more damage and longer distances while the enemy guardian cannot, and thus they're going to take more bullets to actually down you and thus have a longer TTK, but your TTK with the buffed Gallagher or possibly buffed Summoner on range is then going to be much, much less. To showcase this even more so and why this is so vital to understand, what I want to do is I want to go directly back into those private matches and show you a bullet magnetism test, not only at 10 meters, but at 20 meters, showing that range is certainly going to come into play, annihilating, decimating, and eradicating every single guardian in your path if it's higher than the enemy guardians. As I take out that Darcy and measure 10 meters and speed up all these test cases, what you're then going to see is that pretty much across the board on the right-hand side of the head and on the top side of the head, regardless of whether or not we're using the Summoner, the Gallagher with the SLO-10 post sight, or the Gallagher with the SBO-28 front sight, they're pretty much having the same bullet magnetism on both those sides of the head. On the right side of the head, I stopped laying shots just above the shoulder, but on the top side of the head, I stopped laying shots just above the health bar. I don't know about you, but I really couldn't really see that big of a difference, but as soon as I went back to 20 meters, oh yeah, we definitely see a big colossal difference, and the main difference is with the Summoner on the right-hand side of the head. With the Summoner on the right-hand side of the head, I was able to hit far, far outside the hitbox than what I would normally do, But as far as the gallery was on the right-hand side of the head, regardless of whether or not that was with the SLO 10 post sight or the SPO 28 front sight, I really didn't see that big of a difference, at least in contrast to that of the Summoner and the right-hand side of the head. But on the top side of the head, I didn't see a daily squat difference at all. And so this then tells us that if you're going to miss shots, definitely miss shots on the right-hand side of the head, at least when it comes to the Summoner. But as far as the Galliard goes, it's not really going to make a difference because you can pretty much have the same bullet magnetism both in the top side of the head and the right side of the head. And having seen all these tests, the bullet magnetism test, the range test, the sight test, as well as the weapon's TTK stats, its base stats, and even the weapon's perks, which one of these two beauties is actually better than the other? That, DS Layers, is the question of the hour. And so if you were to ask me, there is no doubt in my mind that the clear winner here is the Summoner. And the reason as to why this is because number one, it's going to have a much, much better chance of getting the roll that you want with Zen Moment making the sight a complete laser beam. That right there is so significantly important. I can't even begin to express to you as to how vital that actually is. If you're at cross map distances or in close ranges, it's not going to matter because with that sight and Zen Moment, it's going to land shot after shot after shot, and the same thing is not said for the Galliard. But not just this, the Summoner also happens to have a very, very fast TTK that can compete with the Galliard, but even so, I do gotta give credit where credit is due as the Galliard can roll a kill clip and get that faster TTK on a much more regular basis. When it comes to base stats, the Summoner definitely outplays the Galliard in terms of handling and reload speed, but the Galliard definitely outplays the Summoner in terms of recoil direction and bounce intensity. However, let me ask you this, is that even going to matter? Because I won't lie, the recoil direction and the bounce intensity on the Galliard is definitely better, but it's not going to matter if you happen to have Zen Moment on the Summoner, because that thing just doesn't freaking move, and you're gonna land crit after crit after crit, getting so many delicious, crispy, juicy, spicy plays up in here that Guardians are gonna be completely obliterated by Exodia before they even know what hit them. With that kind of analysis, let me know your guys' thoughts on this down in the comment section below, and no matter what you guys say, you always know that I'm going to respect your opinions, and that is something that I can guarantee. Lastly, be sure to watch the newest, check the latest, and share a comment like on social media, because you are the greatest. That's pretty much all I've got for you right now, DS Layers. And as always, GG TNT.